Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhu Bande Nitta Nanda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nanda Nanga Bande Radhika Charana Dayam Gopijana Samayuktam Binda Vanam Manohar Vāñśākalpa-taru-vaśya-kipā-sindh-bevacha patitānaṁ pāvune-bhavaiṣṇa-vibhyo-namo-namā mūkaṁ karoti-vācālaṁ pangunglaṁ haitagiram yat-kipātam-haṅgvande-paramānanda-vādhava brindhāvi-tulsi-debhvai-piyāvi-kesa-vasya-cha Shna Bhakti Pade Devi Satya Vattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottamam Devin Swaraswating Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Shankirtane Krishna Katho Padesh Gauriya Patrasya Prakasa Necha Shadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramadakshya Jagod Bharvanya Dhaiyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtadoham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam Bhetatiham Punatapalya Bhavadipotam Bande Mahapurushate Charanarvindam Yat Bhada Pallavanakha Chandamani Chattaya Vishpurjita kimapikapavadushvadarsh Purnanuragara sasagara saramurti Sharadhikamai kadakipam karush Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānulambita bhujo kanukā budhātu Saṅkītanaika vitaru kamulā yatākṣo Viṣṁbaru dijabaru jugadharma pālo Bande jagat priyakaru karunā bhatāru Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare. Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibbarupam Bhuktiṃ ca muktiṃ ca dadāsinitam bhāvānu rūpena sadā nārānam Gangā taranga ramaniya jatā kalāpam Gauri nirantara vibhuṣi tobhāṁ bhāgam Nārāyano priyamananga madā puhāram Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatham Vagi Shajusha Vadane Lakshmi Rijasacha Bhakshashi Yasasti Hidai Sambhid Tvam Nishinga Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram Hare Jasho Shakshat Bhagavati Gyanodipa Prade Guru Marto Sadhi Sutam Tasya Sarvam Kunjara Sauchabad Jasho Shakshat Bhagavati Gyanodipa Prade Guru Marto Sadhi Sutam Tasya Sarvam Kunjaro Sauchabad Sisila Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that slightest deviation from the track of your Sadguru can throw you away from bhajan. Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that slightest deviation from the track of your Sadguru Padma can throw you away from bhajan. Also, I would like to speak this advice in such a way. Slightest deviation from the track of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada can throw you away from bhajan. You cannot identify yourself as Saraswat Gauriya devotee. You cannot identify yourself as Saraswat Gauriya devotee if you are deviated from the track of Sadguru Padma, I mean Srila Prabhupada, then you can go out of this bhajan field totally. Different kinds of, you know, suspicion, doubts coming inside your heart about Sadguru Padma Vaishnava. We cannot understand the mood of pure Guru Vaishnava. That is the main problem. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Gauriya Goshtipati, told that those demonic characters, those who are demon, with sannyas base, brahmachari base, or acharya base, Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking. Prabhupada speaking, they are always trying to bring some darkness in the field of bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, if you challenge, I can show you. So maybe you can think I am criticizing, but I have no time to criticize anybody. Believe me or not, no time. And I hate. Srila Gauriya Goshtipati Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told those who are demonic character with sannyas base, brahmachari base, or devotees, they always try to bring some darkness in the field of bhajan. And the duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava is to show light to you all. The only duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava is to show the light to you all, so that you can discover what is bhajan, what is not bhajan, how to move, what to do. You can remember those who are ghost, those who are witch, those who are ghost, they always like to stay in darkness. They always try to stay in darkness. If you like to bring some light, they become very angry. That is the point. They try to indicate that why Prabhupada is going to criticize. In the life of Prabhupada, whole life, we hear from Guru Bhargava, Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Bhumata, I heard from them that people are going against Prabhupada. They misunderstand Prabhupada, they like to point out. Some of them conclude that Prabhupada is a very nice critic. Somebody thinking Prabhupada is a very nice philosopher, but he is criticizing all the time. Prabhupada don't like to speak any sweet, you know, philosophy in front of us. different people passing different kind of comments about Prabhupada. But up to now, a very few people, could understand the mood of Srila Prabhupada. Even those who got the chance to stay with Prabhupada continuously, they also get deviated from the track of Prabhupada totally. They leave Prabhupada mercilessly. This is the condition. Whenever I speak something about Prabhupada, when I want to indicate that this is Siddhanta, this is wrong, I am not going to speak the name of any acharya, anybody. But still, some foolish idiot, they like to pass remark that I am going to... I have no test, I am not getting any test. I have no time to criticize about somebody. Why you come to me? Why not you go to those people from there where you can get more consciousness? Why you come to me? Don't come to me. I am always speaking in front of some selected people, those who are really interested. Why you come to me? Unnecessarily wasting your time. You go there, those who are giving you more consciousness. I am 100% sure. I am 100% sure that you are hearing Harikatha. At the same time, you have connection with those demonic character people, negative world, through your WhatsApp, phone. I know 100%. That's why if you go on hearing infinity period, still I cannot give any guarantee. I cannot give a guarantee to you. I know you are in touch with them. They are passing some remark, this, that. They are very fearful. Because this kind of world can stay up even after my death. They can have the scope to hear all those clearly. Only those who are enjoying 100% Kipa or Sadguru, they can understand my mood, my Siddhanta, where I speak all about Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And those who are innocent, not having no Vaishnava Parad, they can little bit they can understand. But they cannot misunderstand me. But those who are doing commencing aparad, they are 100% going to misunderstand me. So better they leave me. I would suggest them. So actually point is that those who are demonic character, they always try to make darkness in the field of Hari Bhajan, in the field of Bhagavad Bhajan, they feel comfortable there. Nobody can see them, nobody can understand their mood, everything. The sloka I started with is very important, so is giving warning to us. It's from Bhagavatam. Jusho, Krishna Bhagavan speaking to Uddhava. Jusho Shakshad Bhagavati Jnana Deepe Prade Guru Marto Sadhi Sutam Taso Sarvam Kunjara Sauchavat. Guru Vaishnava, those who are going to give you light, I mean Tattva Gyan. Guru Vaishnava, those who are going to give you Tattva Gyan to cut your bondage. If you are going to misunderstand them unnecessarily, in that case all bhajan done up to now and in future all in vain, all in vain. Many times I told before, elephant taking bath, after taking bath, going to spray powder, I mean dust particle from the field. This is their bath. You are also getting this kind of bath. So if you misunderstand Guru Vaishnava unnecessarily, even after pointing out that this is the track of Prabhupada, this is not the track of Prabhupada, still if you cannot understand, because you have done so many aparad, That's why your consciousness going down and down. You are feeling attraction for money, position, how to collect money, position. But Guru Vaishnava spit on this collection of these, that. They spit on that. They know automatically by the desire of Krishna, everything can be done. And be careful. The avasya meva bhaktavyam kritam karma shubha shubham. Any kind of activity is good and bad, what you are doing, you will have to suffer for that. You will have to suffer for that. Nahuktam khyate karmo kalpo koti satai rupi. Nahuktam, without suffering. Nahuktam means, if you are doing some good activities, you can go to heaven, this, that, but you cannot get the scope to reach Vaikuntha Dham. According to your fruitive activities, you can sometimes go to heaven and hell. So, nabhuktam khyate karmo kalpakoti satai rupi. Hundreds of kalpa, you have to travel up and down, up and down. In Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, kobhu raja, kobhu poja. All the time, you have to run up and down. Brahmando bharmite kuro bhagyavan jeev guru krishna prasade pai bhakti lata bij. By the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava you can get. By the mercy of, only by the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava you can get the scope. This kind of scope to get bhakti lata bij and nourishment, it is up to you, you have to do. Savan kitamai. And also many times I told you will have to depend upon right source. Living source. Until and unless you find one glowing personality in front of you, you cannot get inspiration. There is a main problem with bonded soul. Until and unless they can find a glowing personality in front of them, they cannot get any inspiration to do Hari Bhajan properly. That is the main problem. But bonded soul, traveling 14 worlds all the time they think I am very intelligent, they think I have enough of tattva-gyan, but I can prove no tattva-gyan is there. To memorize some tattva and to feel some tattva, not the same. In Mundak Upanishad we can find, avidyayam antare vartamanaha svayam dhiraha panditamannamanaha jangdammanaha parishanti mooda andhen naivo niyamana yathandha. Mundaka Upanishad 1-8. Avidyayam antare vartamanaha. I think I am great pandit. I realize everything. But I myself is in darkness. How I can guide others? Not possible. So avidyayam antare vartamanaha svayam dhiraha panditamannamana. They think we are dhir, we are panditamannamana, we are great pandit. They always feel proud of that. We are great pandit, we realize everything. Parishanti mura. And they are traveling 14 world all the time. They are traveling 14 world all the time. They are really fickle-minded personality. They have no stability of mind. Sometimes they think this is good. And tomorrow think, no, it is not good. Day after tomorrow can grow some other attachment. This way they can go on traveling for infinity period. I have no responsibility for them. I have no responsibility for them. They can do whatever they like. Because I can promise by touching the lotus feet of Prabhupada, I can touch the lotus feet of Prabhupada and say, I never want to be guru. I never want to be guru. I never want to be guru. I never. This is my resolution. If somebody can break this resolution, I will be very happy. Because before leaving this world, I can at least make one torch I can hand over this torch to somebody who can show light to others. But I myself never go on. I am a very safe position. I never want to become guru. Those who want to become guru by their own desire, but or by the desire of somebody who give them advice, you try to act as guru, it's very good. I pay dandavat unto the lotus feet of all of them, because they are all my shiksha guru. They are going to prove the far-reaching consequence. They want to see the result of their life. They want to teach me indirectly. So they, all my shiksha guru, I like to pay dandavat unto their lotus feet. I am not going to fight with them, not at all. Those who want to become guru by their own desire or by the advice of somebody else, and those who are acting as guru, and their painful position can prove, oh Maharaj, you never try, oh Baba, you never try to become guru. You see the position. Through election, it is not possible to elect one guru, Prabhupada told. Self-manifested. Guru you cannot select through election. It's not possible. And if at all some election can be done, and if somebody can, and some by PBS Acharya, if somebody is made Acharya at present, maybe I am not going to speak any, because I have no interest. If I have at all any interest, then I can have some envious attitude. But I have no interest. I have no interest actually. So how I can feel? So it is one kind of punishment. It is one kind of punishment. It is not actually, they can discover, they cannot confess. They cannot confess in public, but they are speaking inside heart. Oh Maharaj, this is one kind of punishment. Great punishment. You wanted to become guru, that's why Gurudev wanted to make you guru, I mean loghu, to get punishment. That is the topmost punishment one can expect in life. They are getting punishment. This is punishment. I am not speaking about all. Not speaking about all. I am not getting any bribe. I am not getting any bribe from Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. I am not getting any bribe from any other Acharya so that I can speak in favor of them. Why I am not going to pass any bad remark? Why I am not, you know, become angry when they are speaking something, when they are doing something, when they are writing something? Why I am not, I have taken some bribe from them, you think? You foolish? Huh? When Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj took trouble to add some small note on Chaitanya Charitamrita, very small note, it was very urgent. I was also feeling for a long time, but I was not at all angry. Why? When I saw that it was full anugatha, is full submission, with crying mood, with appealing mood, he wrote, he was bound to write. I was very happy when I saw they are extremely necessary, very urgent. But when somebody is going to write some comment on Chaitanya, I become very angry. Why? I have no enmity with anybody, not at all. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not become angry when Sarvam Vattacharya going to change some word from Bhagavatam? Gyane prayasa mudabanta mudabasva namanti eva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam sthanisthita sutigatam tonubang manovhirji slok. This slok. Sarvam Vattacharya wanted to change one word, that I cannot use this word, mukto. Mukto, this word I cannot. Mukti, I cannot. Jiveto bhakti pade sa dai bhag. Now, my question in front of you are very intelligent, I know you are very intelligent, more than Guru Vaishnava. I am asking you, why Mahaprabhu not become angry with that? I am discussing about the, activities of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasavana. I am discussing within this area. I am not going outside. Like mathematics, I can prove after. I conclude. Why Mahaprabhu not become angry? Because Mahaprabhu could realize the heart of Sarvam Bhattacharya. Previously, Mahaprabhu was not at all ready to accept any Siddhanta by Sarvam Bhattacharya. Maybe the whole world can, speak that Sarvam Bhattacharya is great Pandit. But Mahaprabhu was not at all ready to confess this point. I can give many examples. Because Mahaprabhu could realize that now the mood of Sarvam Bhattacharya is totally changed. His heart is totally melted by bhakti. Mahaprabhu speaking, why you are going to change the sloka? Jibeto bhakti padesha. It is originally it is written Jibeto mukti padesha bhag. Prabhu, I cannot speak this word mukti. What problem? If you can change this grammatical calculation little bit, mukti jar pade, same mukti pad, jibeto mukti pade, you can explanation little bit change in grammar. Mukti jar pade iti mukti pad, mukti resting unto the lotus feet of Krishna, this way if you can explain, Prabhu, still today no more I can use this word mukti. Enough of it. Whole my life gone, Prabhu. With all my disciples, with all my students, day and night like jackal I was I was used to speak. But now I cannot speak. Please excuse me. Prabhu was very happy. Why Prabhupada was not angry when Radhakanta Brahmachari, Radharaman Brahmachari, Santo Goswami Maharaj wrote, Guru Shevak hoy, Guru Swaru, Jibe Swarup hoy Krishna Nitya Das, Jibe Swarup hoy Guru Nitya Das. Why Prabhupada was not angry? Because he changed the original version. Because Prabhupada could realize the heart of Radharaman. When complaint came, Prabhupada was very happy to answer. You see, actually Radharaman small boy, but the Siddhanta is really perfect. Guru, Jive Swarup hoy Guru Nitya Das. And you are in the ocean of Mayavad. That's why you cannot believe pure Guru Vaishnava. I know you. That's why I told you, you are feeling very sorry that we all are more or less contaminated with Mahavad Siddhanta. Because we have some doubt. Why Maharaj speaking this way? Why that Maharaj speaking this way? Eh? This is the point. So Prabhupada was not angry because really so. Jive Swarup hoy Guru Nitya Das. Without Guru, we have no identity. Without Guru, we have no identity, no identity, no identity we have. What I can do without Guru? If you are lucky enough, you can understand this kind of Siddhanta. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. If some foolish people cannot understand my Siddhanta, what can be more, what can be more positive factor for me? What can be more enjoyment than that? I don't like to unveil this mystery in front of all common public. You are those who are eating stool and urine whole day and night. Let them go there. Let them go there. They lick. It's very good. Why they are coming to lick honey? Mahaprabhu in his whole life never teach us, never teach us to come to enter into any kind of compromise with anybody. Be it the case of, you know, Madhacharya Sipat, Udupi, or be it the case of, you know, there in Varanasi, in front of Prakasananda, Mahaprabhu never accepted. Mahaprabhu never accepted. When Prakasananda was asking, well, you are doing Sankirtan, it's okay. Why you are not coming to hear Vedanta? Mahaprabhu wanted to cheat them. Because they are cheater. If you are cheater, I am going to cheat you. Sate Satyam. In Mahabharata it is written, Sate Satyam. If you are sort cheater, I can also cheat you. Be sure. If you are cheater, I can cheat you also. Different way. I can give garland to you. I can say, oh, Prabhu, you are great poet. You are, you know, great philosopher, this, that, and I can cheat you. If you are cheater, I can, 100% I can cheat you. But if you have no cheating propensity, if you are humble, you are 100% inclined, you want to know the absolute truth, then and only then I can help you. I have no time. So you see, when asking to Mahaprabhu, it's okay you are doing kirtan, why not coming to attend Vedanta Darshan Charcha? Why you are not coming to hear Vedanta? Mahaprabhu say, Guru More Murkho Deki Korilo Shasan. Tumi Murkho Tomar Vedante Nahi Adhikar. Mahaprabhu speaking. Mahaprabhu just cheating them. Mahaprabhu speaking, actually point is that I cannot come to hear Vedanta because I am foolish. My Guru Maharaj told you are Murkha, you are foolish. So you go on doing Sankirtan. Tumi Murkho Tomar Vedante Nahi Adhikar. You have no right in Vedanta. So you go on here, you know, doing Sankirtan. So I started doing Kirtan. I am dancing and crying, not according to my, you know, own desire. Hasi Kadi Nahi Ami Apon Ichhai. I am not laughing, crying, dancing, not according to my own desire. One day I put question to Guru Maharaj, Mahaprabhu speaking. I was bound to put this question in front of my Gurudev. Why this kind of situation creating in my life, happening? I cannot stand, I start dancing, singing. Then Guru advised me, oh, this is the actual result of your Harinam. This is the ultimate result of your Harinam. Why you become ori with that? Very happy. You should be very happy. Krishnanam, if you go on doing, if you are getting the seed from Sadguru, be careful, I am always speaking same thing. If you have the chance to get Harinam and Diksha from Sadguru, because otherwise there is no power, Birja is not there. If I give mantra to you, what use? If that mantra is not effective in my own life, if Birja is not there, that's why many times I told, it in Shastra it is written, that why you are going to plant a tree in a desert? Because the plant cannot survive, can die. In sand, in a sandy place, if you put seed, surely it's going to die. Follow. If you are going to give your daughter to such a man who is not man, not woman, half woman, what use? You cannot expect from your daughter one grandson. This is a big problem. And why you are going to take diksha from a bonded soul, then you are not going to get. Apatre mantra dan, which is not actual pot, Sadguru never like to give mantra. Or at all give, if someday they fall down, it is their duty, someday they can rescue them, next life, next life, next life. So when, I cannot say. Many such incidents happen. They are so puffed up, they are so false ego, they like to ignore Prabhupada. They like to ignore Prabhupada, they throw Prabhupada, writing against Prabhupada, against Gauriya Math. After that, they fall down. They fall down, they take diksha from another guru. I have document. They took diksha from another guru. They are advising other, you know, godbrother, who also took diksha from Prabhupada. Prabhu, I already get result. I took diksha from that Maharaj. So you can also suggesting. But what? Last life? What is the conclusion? Last life? Last life, when they are going to die, before death, they are running around Radha Kunda. One of them, I am speaking, not about all. One of them, I am not going to criticize. I have direct document. Night time, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, running around Radha Kunda. Oh, Prabhupada! Oh, Prabhupada! Oh, Prabhupada! I have done mistake. I have done mistake. Please excuse me. Why? And in front of disciple, he called before death, calling all disciple and speaking, you see me! You look at me! You look at me! My result! You say, you see my result. I leave Prabhupada. This is my result. Another partner, before death, before living body for the previous 5 years, a son and daughter is going to give water, bucket of bucket water on head. Bucket of bucket water on head to cool down the brain. Because brain gone out of order, writing against Prabhupada, Ragadin writing against, you know, Gauriya Math. Oh, I can show you a document. Then you cannot say that I am going to criticize. I spit on criticism. I have no time. Don't speak like that. Don't speak like that. I have no time to criticize. Great offense you are doing. Better you can stop my speech. I like to stop and go. Get lost in Vrindavan. I have no responsibility for you all. This is the situation. Those who are doing aparadha and trural rasvira Prabhupada and Gauriya Math, you go and do scrutiny of their life. You can find how they die. Then you can understand. They have done offense or not. If something negative going on, if I speak to stop, that's why Prabhupada many times told to arrest the current perverted tide of this, you know, fanatic world is a seemingly unpleasant duty of Gauriya Math. That's why you are not feeling comfortable. I know. Because you are going to keep track, both sides. Satsanga, asatsanga, both you like to do. Knowingly, unknowingly. You think I don't know? One day, suddenly, I ring to Prabhuji, you write one line. You write one line to one Mataji. He saying, why? You write one line. Suddenly, I don't know why. After, you know, that I speak, you write one line to Mataji. I know he sees in Maya. Only one line. No Dandavat, nothing, one line. Mara speaking, be careful about Maya. It is the arrangement of Nityananda. It is the arrangement of Guru. I don't know why. I have deep relationship with you all. What you feel, that's surely coming to me, touch my heart. I can give answer to you later also. I have no time at present. So try to keep faith. Try to keep faith. Automatic. I have no capacity. Automatic, it's an automatic factor. So you see, how you can discover your weakness? If you like to fly here and there, like to get some lab puja pratishtha, you are busy to collect money. Oh, what I can do if my money is lost? Hari, what I can do? What I can do? You should think what I can do. I believe on Nityananda Prabhu. If you like to discover your weakness, please be careful. If you like to discover your weakness, what all weakness is there inside your heart, you will have to come in front of a pure Vaishnava. From heart, you will have to come. If you don't come in front of a pure sadhu, you cannot understand your weakness. Be careful. If I cannot meet with Himalaya, I cannot understand my teeny feature. If you can come in front of Sadhugu, if you have that kind of power, if you don't have that kind of capacity, you go. Go anywhere you can go. If you like to discover your weakness, if you have no duplicity inside your heart, you will have to come in front of a pure Vaishnava and automatically you can discover. Oh Maharaj, so much dirty things are there inside my heart. You like to hide yourself. Be careful. One poisonous snake. A poisonous snake always try to fly very quickly so that nobody can see. Because that snake is poisonous, always like to do some problem, bite somebody. But any snake having no poison, I have seen myself, is traveling very slowly, very slowly. You know, everybody is sure that nobody can kill me because I am not going to bite anybody. That's why those who are having weakness, they don't like to come in front of me. They don't like to come in front of me. I am not Acharya, I am nothing. But I don't know. I like to follow Prabhupada. This much I can say. They cannot come in front of me. If some Harikatha going on, they let us stop it, stop it. We don't like to hear. Why? Because you have weakness. That's why you cannot hear. It is impossible for you to hear. Because you have weakness. You like to take care of your weakness. You like to preserve your weakness whole life. Birth after birth, life after life, you like to preserve. You like to keep intact. Or you like to increase the quality of your weakness. So that you can go and go and go deep into the ocean of darkness. Ocean of darkness. That's why you like to avoid. That's why you like to avoid. That is your, you know, mood. I already told from Mundaka Upanishad. Why people traveling all around this 14 world all the time? Avidyayam antare vartamanah shayam dhiraha panditamannamanah jangdandamanah parishanti mura ande naivo niyamana yathandha. They think themselves we are very intelligent. We understand everything. But they understand nothing. They realize nothing. On behalf of Vishwavishnava Prasabha, it is written, those who can 100% promise and can say, they can touch their own heart and speak with full resolution that I am not Sahajya, I am going to follow Rupa Goswami step by step. Only and only they can come and join Vishwavaishnava Brahmasabha. Only they can join Vishwavaishnava Brahmasabha. Those who are going to claim 100% I like to follow Rupa Goswami path in toto. Gradually, I like to follow. I don't like to jump. So, why they are traveling all around this world, birth after birth? Why? They think we are very intelligent, we are acharya, we are, you know, great pandit. So, though they are going to travel all around, they have no faith in pure Guru Vaishnava. That's why they can be guided, they will be guided by a blind man. Andha yathandhai rupaniyamanam teyo pisechatanta murudan nibadhya. They are blind, they are going to follow a blind man, so they can go, both of them, they can fall down in the ocean of darkness. So what is problem to us? Never you can feel power inside your Guru Vaishnava inside your heart until and unless you are 100% interested to avoid material enjoyment mood. Until and unless you are going to avoid from your heart, this is an automatic factor. It's an automatic. If you feel attraction to Harikatha, automatically you can feel, you can see that all material enjoyment not going to stand inside my heart no more. Prahlad Maharaj speaking in 7th canto, giving guarantee. Vimunchati yada kamano manavo manose sthitano tarhi eva pundarikaksho bhagavataya kalpate. Vimunchati yada kamano manavo manose sthitano. All different kind of demands and enjoying moods are there inside your heart, because you are not following Guru Vaishnava properly. Otherwise, by this time, you should have a proper chance to go out of Maya. But you yourself going to preserve it, what I can do? Vimunchati yada kamano manabo manabo manusisthitano. If I am going to leave all my desire, if I am successful to leave all desire for my clean, then and there I can get the power of Guru. I can get the power of Nityananda. Surely. Tarhi evo, tarhi mane instant. Tarhi evo. Jarhi evo, tarhi evo. In Sanskrit we say, jarhi. When, then. Tarhi, then. Jarhi mane jakhon, when. Tarhi, then, tarhi eva pundarikaksha, he Prabhu, when man can clean all desire from heart, then and there he can feel some tremendous power. Tremendous power inside heart. What to speak about Maya? Maya, nothing. What Maya can do? Tarhi eva pundarikaksha bhagavataya kalpate. Then the power of Bhagavan coming inside them. Those who are going to cut. But with very sweet mood, I am not speaking about Mayavadi. Those who are devotee, if they can grow deep and deep relationship with Guru Vaishnava, because Guru Vaishnava always try to make a deep relationship. It's an automatic. Maybe Gurudev is there thousands of miles away. But he can realize the heart. He can realize the mood, what I have inside my mind. So, vimunchati yada kamano manavo manusya sthitano tarhi eva pundarikaksho bhagavataya kalpate. Then and there he can feel power. Automatically, and all demigods also then, when they can discover that, no, we cannot stop him. We cannot stop him. He is going to grow tremendous bhakti power for Gurudev. Then all demigods, they are also going to cooperate. Previously they can try to put him in trouble. But after they discover, no, we cannot stop him. He is 100%, you know, no duplicity is there. He is going to do bhajan. Then they can help you. Not before that. So also, in Boli Maharaj, when Boli Maharaj was bonded, then Brahma, all they are speaking, Prabhu, you are giving punishment to him. Boli Maharaj, in front of Brahmandev, Prabhu, he already gave everything to you. He should not get punishment, Prabhu. Why you are putting him in trouble? Then Prabhu laughing and speaking, Brahman, you don't know whom I love from heart. I like to snatch everything, all property, all bodily energy, enjoyment, everything, all mood I can take away. Brahman, jam anugrinnami tad visho vidunomi aham. I like to clean his heart. I like to clean his mood so that he can never in future can express some false mood. Because usually it is seen, janmo ishojjo sruto sri, if you have, automatically, I am staying in America, I am very rich, you are rich, but I can prove that you are very poor. You can think, I am very rich, I am staying in France, Italy, but you are, I can prove that you are very poor. So, Brahman Jan Anugrinhami, whom I go to accept, I like to bless, tad visho vidunomiyam, I like to vidunomi, mean vishes, very specially I like to clean his heart. So that, janamadaha purushaha stabdho, lokang mancha abamannate. Because if false ego is there, then surely you are going to insult pure Guru Vaishnava. You are going to express some doubt about your Guru Vaishnava and, you know, Supreme Lord, his parshad. Surely, you cannot avoid. Jan madaha, because madha mean false ego. That's why Kunti Devi was bound to speak. Janma isajya suto sivi re dhamano madaha pumano naivar vati abhidatum vaitama kinchana gocharam. If you like to get the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, first I like to see you have taken resolution or not. If you are 100% sure that there is no desire inside my heart, I like to get the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I like to enter into eternal world, to get eternal service, then why not you try today? What you are doing whole day? What you are doing whole day? What is your program? You are wasting your time. So each and every fraction of second you will have to utilize for the seva of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. If you get habituated at present, then after living body you can get. If you are not practicing, you are not having that kind of, how you can expect? What you are doing is sadhana, you can get in siddhi. Jang jang bhaupi swaranam bhavam tajati ante kalevaram. You have to go through this sloka. So actually, you have to feel all these points. If you become angry with me, that's not solution. I already told, my heavy speech can prove my endless affection to you all. 100%. It can prove my endless affection for you all. Be careful. So, on behalf of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha, I am bound to speak all these things. Whole world going inside darkness, false philosophy, without any realization, if you like to write something, speak something, you can get heavy punishment. I know you would like to become a lecturer. Without any feeling, if you like to pass lecture, you can get heavy punishment. Be careful. So try to do bhajan and try to realize practical realization, not false. One day, Srila Gaurakishor Babaji Maharaj speaking to Bimala Prasad, "My Prabhu, don't try to teach Chaitanya Charitamrita to that fellow, that guy. Don't try to teach. He is going to put pranami thala, one plate of pranami, so that part going on, pranami can come, he can collect and lead his fanciful life. Don't try to teach anything. Maybe he can approach you. You can say, I have no time. Gaurakishor Babaji, come on, Gaurakishor Babaji must be." He's speaking, they are interested about money. Artholab eyase bhumiya phiri deshe deshe. I am traveling all about the world. Why? I am preaching or collecting money? What I am doing? Preaching? If preaching you show, you will have to show that you have changed in any bonnet show. Or you can show you are successful to change your own heart. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, I am not speaking anything new. Only you are blind, I like to show you, point out. Artholab eyase bhumiya phiri deshe deshe. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. So, actual preaching men, Prabhupada speaking, you will have to preach in front of yourself first. You will have to preach in front of you first. You will have to preach in front of you first. If that preaching is done perfect, then you can go outside. If your preaching is not successful in front of yourself, how you can go for preaching to others? So preaching should be done in front of yourself first. If you are successful, then you can, by the desire of Nityananda Guru Varga, you can start preaching, if at all, this kind of. So, all the activities of bonded soul are very dangerous. All the activities of bonded soul is very dangerous. They never want to obey Guru Vaishnava. They can hear Harikatha, but they cannot apply in their own life. They cannot apply in their own life. That is the main problem. So Mahaprabhu, I already told, Mahaprabhu is the king. I mean Krishna Chandra is the king of Vishwavijaya Rasava. And the right hand is Rupa Goswami Pad, and to whom is worshipable personality, Barenyo mean worshipable. We can accept him, his idealism in our life. He is Sanatan. Sanatan was given a special chair so that he can preserve all rules and regulations set. And I already told that Shata Sandarbha is a topmost weapon to crush the hate of all demonic character people. Shata Sandarbha is a topmost weapon. There we can get all anushasan. All the rules and regulations, Siddhanta, everything said by Rupa Sanatan, all we can get in Shata Sandarbha by the mercy of Jiva Goswami Pad, who compiled, who was bound to compile for us all. There can be no doubt in our life. So Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava is not a matter of joke. Those who can Solemnly, those who can say that I am 100% going to Rupa Goswami Pad, not at all. If they are not going to follow Prabhupada, how we can expect? If they are not at all going to follow Prabhupada, they are making some different explanation, different thing, they criticize, they like to throw, kick, you know, then how I can expect? They are Rupanuga. You can fight, that is up to you. It's an automatic factor. So Vishwa Vaishnava Ras Sabha is eternally present in eternal world. Gauriya Math is also eternally present in eternal world. Forcefully you cannot get entry into Gauriya Math. Forcefully you cannot get entry into Gauriya Math. Only you can make some garbage. I already told a few minutes before that three condition there. You cannot seed, you cannot put seed on sand. You cannot give your daughter to such a personality who is not man, woman, half man, half woman. And if you're going to give mantra to useless, because those who are less interested, they are feeling very comfortable with material thing. This is not the time to get diksha. At least if you think that this may all material things in this material world is all unstable, nothing can give me enjoyment. They are always having some business mood. Business mood. They buy this flat, 40 lakhs, they like to sell 60-70 lakhs. This is their mood. How we can expect? They have received diksha from any Gurudev, or at all haven't taken. This Gurudev is also businessman, I think. Otherwise, he is going to, this kind of, Are you should give free of cost for this excellent reason. Foolish number one. He like to gather money. Every now and then people going to die out of corona heart attack. You are making calculation. This much money you can have and this much you can get in future. Foolish number one. You are Gaudiya devotee, huh? Eh? This way you get training from Prabhupada. From whom you got? From whom you teach, learn to do business? So, Vishwa Vaishnava Ras Sabha, you see, were eternally present, and those who are going to take shelter of Vishwa Vaishnava Ras Sabha, 100% they are not going to get lost, because this is the responsibility of Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, to protect those Jivatmas, those who are going to take shelter of Vishwa Vaishnava Ras Sabha at any cost. So in the show, actually in the year of 1919, 4th February, by the desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by then Bhaktivinoda Thakur already gone 4 years over. Bhaktivinoda Thakur leave body in the year of, 1914. And now, 1919, 4th February, a little bit calculation. So, Prabhupada, by the desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada wanted to establish Vishwa Vaishnava Ras Sabha, not a matter of joke. I can make nice politics with this issue. I am also, who are you? Who are you? Vishwa Vaishnava Ras Sabha, not a matter of joke. So, then it was established, and in different newspaper also it was, published. Different newspaper it was published also. So, Prabhupada wanted to establish this for, re-establish this in Bhaktivinoda Asan. Bhaktivinoda Asan means number 1 Ultra Dengue Junction in North Calcutta. Number one, Ultradingi Johnson. There, Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava was re-established, and when actually it was Maghi Panchami, Maghi Shukla, I mean the Abhirbhav Tithi of Vishnupriya Devi. Vishnupriya Devi is the symbol of Shuddha Saraswati. So now you understand the inner meaning. Why Prabhupada wanted to establish on the same day, re-establish? Shuklo, Maghi Shukla Panchami, I mean the Abhirbhav Tithi of Vishnupriya Devi, Abhirbhav Tithi, because by then Prabhupada already declared that Sri Jagannath Babaji Maharaj already declared that Vishnupriya Devi, this is the Abhirbhav Tithi of Vishnupriya Devi, and you will have to run accordingly. So Prabhupada already got this advice from Jagannath Das Babaji, so accordingly he wanted. So it was established on the special day. I already told all the eternal parsad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Sanatan, Rupa Goswami Pad, Gopal Bhatto Goswami, Raghunath Bhatto, Raghunath Das, Jiva Goswami Pad, all the bright star in the sky of Gauriya Vaishnava society. When after that, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone, after 11 years over, then suddenly darkness coming. Then they could realize that we'll have to take precautionary measure. So we cannot allow darkness to come. I know those who are demonic character, they like to stop Harikatha, stop this kind of discussion to bring darkness, because they are ghost. They like to stay in darkness. They can get different privilege to do some wrong activities. So, until and unless I am going to get certificate from Swarup Gosai, any product in any company should be tested before sending in market. So before going to for pitching world, you will have to appear in testing. Swarup Gosai can test you. I mean, Prabhupada can test you. Swarup Gosai gone, but Prabhupada is the topmost examiner. Prabhupada is the topmost examiner. If we are going to get certificate from Prabhupada, yes, you can go. Like Prabhupada giving order to Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, you can go for Harikatha, you can go for fishing. And with this order, Prabhupada also giving power. If I think I have done big preaching, then it is not at all preaching. It is not at all preaching. If I am not going to speak anything about Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, I am speaking all about what I feel, what I understand, I feel. That is not preaching. You will have to speak about Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. The other day, one devotee from Jalandhar, he is staying in Vrindavan. I don't know what he is doing. He asks me permission to do something. He give order to somebody. They are making small, advice and giving my picture. Immediately yesterday I told them, you will have to give the picture of Prabhupada. At all, if like to people interested who speaking, then you can speak that this fellow, speaking. But first of all, you have to project Prabhupada. You will have to project. Now situation is very critical. All you will have to spend your money to preach Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, all the time you have to speak. So, okay, you can speak that Prabhupada speaking, because I am speaking about Prabhupada. If you put my name, it is not good. Okay, you can put the Sambhava speaking this Harikatha. This much you can say. This I told. Follow what I say. So all the time we will have to be very careful about what Prabhupada wanted to do. That is main thing. If I am not speaking anything about Prabhupada, I am not at all from Saraswat Gauri Sampradaya. Not at all. So, in Sajjan Tasani and everywhere it was published, the curricula, again, all agenda, everything. So, after Sara Goswami gone, then after Loknath Goswami or Narottama Thakur, after that Narottama Thakur, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Baladev Vidyabhushan, all there, big mega star. They are big mega star. They are going to give light to the whole society. You can run this way. Without light, how you can lead your life? How you can lead your life? You can collect billions of dollars. So what it concerns to me? What you can do? This money power can also make you, put you in trouble. You can fall down. Because automatically you can feel, and money power, I have money power. So you cannot, you, automatically, it's an automatic factor. You can ignore pure guru. Why? Who is he? Useless. Rich man, they are speaking that we can give pranami, 2,000, 5,000, automatically we can get Vaishnav. They are idiot number one, rascal. They are speaking, passing this kind of remark. They are in Bengali. Bhatcharale kake rabhavayana. They are speaking. If we put some rice around, then crow, all crow can come today. You think Vaishnav, they are crow? You are rascal number one. You speaking, you think that Vaishnav, they are crow? Life after life, you can die. And take birth as a worm of stool. If this kind of remark I heard, not directly, indirectly. Directly by heart, I can chase them. I don't care. He's speaking. Arre, if we can give 2,000, 5,000 Brahmi, automatically we can get Vaishnav. Really? Vaishnav is so cheap, like you. Vaishnav is so cheap, like you, na? If you can give pranami, they can speak. If somebody giving pranami, then I like to know what reason. Why he is giving pranami? What seva he expect? He is going to give some order. You will have to arrange one bandara. I can give back money. You keep money with you, I don't need. I can spend this money for publication maybe. For computer job, this I am paying. Translation, this I am doing. But I cannot run according to your will. I cannot run my life according to your will. You see? So this way, you see, all Jiva Goswami, after Jiva Goswami path gone, all Loknath Goswami, all different, you know, Vaishnavas, they are acting as a mega star to show light to the whole society. Why it was established at all? Because at the time of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, by the influence of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it was possible for us to run life that time. It was possible. After that, then also, that time also Mahaprabhu used to protest. No, many times. In Urupi, Mahaprabhu speaking, very polite mood. Oh, you are watching that I am actually Mayavadi Sannyasi. That's why you are not speaking anything perfect about Shaddha Sadhana Tattva. Mahaprabhu is so clever. Mahaprabhu speaking, oh, you discover me that I am actually Mayavadi Sannyasi. That's why you are not speaking all the secrecy of Shaddha Sadhana Tattva. Otherwise, why you are going to speak that way? What is the ultimate goal of Shaddha Sadhana Tattva? Then they become very, feel shy, really so. What you are speaking is perfect. But Acharya, actually, Pokasana Saraswati also was bound to confess in front of Mahaprabhu. in front of Mahaprabhu Prakashananda, together with thousands of disciples, Mayavad Shishya, that Mayavad Guru, Prakashananda was bound to confess in front of Prabhu. Prabhu, actually, what you say, it is perfect. But what to do according to a sampradayic instruction, what Acharya wrote, we are following this. What you are speaking is okay. So, with very polite mood, Mahaprabhu used to rectify. All the time, anywhere. Srirangam, you see, when Venkat Bhatto, Tirumalla Bhatto there, they are speaking about Lakshmi Narayan or Shiv is the topmost. Mahaprabhu with laughing mood speaking. Then why Lakshmi Devi always doing austerity and penances to get the association of Krishna? If Lakshmi Narayan is topmost of bhajan, idealism, then why your Lakshmi Thakurani, why taking trouble to go to Belvan, you know, in Vrindavan, to do bhajan to get the association of Krishna? Why you are joking with me? It's all the same. I know. It's all the same. Narayan and Krishna, no different. But still, as you are saying, I am going to give you argument. What's the reason? Then, Mahaprabhu giving argument. This very polite way, very softly, Mahaprabhu was bound to change their mood. Change their mood. They are very cutter. They are prejudicial idea. Always they are fixed up in their own siddhanta. There nobody can change their mood even one centimeter, 1 millimeter. They can change. They are so fixed up. But still Mahaprabhu, out of his very humble mood and perfect siddhanta, be careful. I learn it from my Guru Bhargava. I learn it from Prabhupada. I learn it from Keshav Goswami Maharaj. I learn it from Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. I learn it from my Guru Maharaj, always. If somebody asking, Maharaj, what is more important? Acharan is important or preaching is important? What I can say? I can say Acharan is more important. If somebody asking, Maharaj, which is very important? Which is very important? Is Acharan or preaching? I am bound to say that Acharan is very important. Because without Acharan, preaching has got no meaning. Many people used to come in front of Guru Maharaj. Maharaj, I like to take sannyas, go for preaching. What bhajan? What preaching? Do bhajan? What preaching? Do bhajan. First of all, do bhajan. Man, come on, you don't know the power of an acharanshil sadhu. You don't know. You don't know. You cannot gaze even. Even in dream, you cannot understand. What is the power of acharan? What is the power of acharan? Follow. In front of acharanshil sadhu, those who are totally established in acharan, those who are totally established in acharan, in front of those sadhu, those who are having some weak point, they cannot come. Acharan is so powerful. In sabha, if our Keshav Goswami Maharaj is there, and some other sahajya there, they cannot open their mouth in front of Keshav Goswami Maharaj. I am proud that my Guru Path Padma is Keshav Goswami Maharaj. My Guru Path Padma is Sridhar Goswami. I am fully proud. I am always feeling proud. In front of them, no sahajya can open their mouth. No sahajya. Because then and there they can arrest them. Hey, what you are speaking? Many such cases happen. Nobody can understand what they can understand about Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha. Whereas they don't understand about the chairman of a Sabha. Chairman of a Vaishnava Sabha, they think we can run Sabha fancifully. If they have some friendship with one Maharaj, now this Maharaj, Dham Bhushan, he is the ornament of Bhushan, he can speak idiot number one. He is also ornament of this Dham. That's why he is going to declare he is also ornament of this Bhushan. Both of them ornament. I know what kind of ornament. False ornament. They can allow, this Maharaj can speak half an hour. We are eagerfully waiting to hear him. And this, if some poor Maharaj coming, he cannot see him. Oh, yogi, if we can get time, 5 minutes we can give you. Hare Maharaj. This is the condition. But we have seen in the life of Santo Goswami Maharaj. You know, so powerful, sitting as a Sabhapati. What is the duty of Sabhapati, you know? You know the duty of Sabhapati, not to play politics. You have friendship with that Maharaj, you can allow him. Like-minded people. Rajastama prakatayo samasila vajanti boi. Birds of same feather flocks together. It's quite natural. But Santo Goswami Maharaj and our Guru Varga was not like that. Maharaj giving order to some devotee, hey, you speak Harikatha. He is speaking Harikatha. After, hey, you can speak 15 minutes. After speaking 15 minutes, he is looking at Maharaj to stop Harikatha or to continue. Maharaj giving signal, you go on speaking. But now, if you speak about Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are going to stop Harikatha. Dung! Stop, stop, time is over. Even 10 minutes is not over. They allow 15 minutes because they cannot digest. They like to stop. So why not they go to political ground? They can come out successful as a political leader. Why they are necessary coming in the spiritual field to make dirt, make garbage? All their activity, their mood, everything can prove that they are political leader. They are not. What is the duty of a Sabhapati? You know? Can you give me answer? What is the duty of a chairman of a Sabha? The duty of a chairman of a Sabha is to give maximum benefit to the audience. Foolish number one. To give maximum most benefit. So we have to search if there is any realized soul. Maybe he is poor, not having temple, nothing. But still, the Sabhapati can allow. That's why in Balighai, Prabhupada Bimala Prasad was giving order, you will have to give judgment. We select you. We like to hear from you this judgment. Brahman Vaishnav. Glory. Glory is of Brahman and Vaishnav. And to establish Siddhanta, thus Vaishnav is more and more and more and more than Brahman. They have to prove. But nobody knows. They don't understand. They think it is our mot because Gurudev write in our name. So it is our, property. Okay, you try to digest. I cannot digest even a single penny. I cannot digest even a single penny if I cannot do bhajan. One day, I am not established in acharan. I am trying at least. I am trying, this much I can say. I am not speaking that I am established in acharan. I am trying, honestly, I am trying. One disciple of Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, long ago, maybe it is 12, 13 years back, now he is no more, one brahmachari. Srila Bhaman Goswami Maharaj used to joke with him, his disciple, Bardha, elder brother. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj used to joke with him, Bardha, ki khabar, what is the news? Bardha, because everybody is speaking you, Bardha, elder brother. So I also used to speak you, Bardha, he's educated, but looks like very madman. His handwriting was so good, he's no more with us. One day he's speaking, suddenly, I was in Maybe I was in Durgapur or somewhere, I cannot remember. I forget. He's speaking, Maharaj, the way you are writing and speaking, you know, in place of you, if somebody else, then you would have get a heavy punishment. In place of you, somebody else, they could kill him. I say, Bardha, why they are not going to kill me? Eh? I mean, laughing mood, I am speaking. Bardha, I am speaking in Vyasasan. I am intact what he told, I am speaking. Bardha, why they are not going to kill me? Why? Many times they threaten me. We can kill you, get ready to go to Jomalaya. I am in very laughing mood, say, oh, I am very lucky. Jamraj is great Vaishnav. If you send me to Jomalaya, I can get the chance to see that Vaishnav. So I am very lucky. Myself, my personal effort, I cannot go to see the lotus feet of Jamraj. I am not become angry. I am giving answer this way. Those who are speaking all rubbish, all crude language, to speak all rubbish against me, but still I am not angry. Bharati Maharaj one day started laughing. Bharati Maharaj started laughing very loudly. I speak to some brahmachari who speak, because I was bound to speak Siddhanta. He become very angry. Get ready to go to Jomalaya. I say, okay, I'm ready. When you can give me appointment, when you can send me. Then I write in the answer in so polite mood. After that, I'm going to say, in the conclusion, when truly yours in the service of ice, right now, like this in Bengali. Iti, his name I write. Iti, after that I cannot speak his name because he is now big Maharaj. If I speak, it's very bad. So I cannot speak his name. So he's understood. Iti ekspadasyo. I am not going to speak his name. Iti ekspadasyo. Tibro krodho prasamanayaha. Tasyo putro Shidas Baba. He is speaking all rubbish. He can kick me, this, that. I say, I identify myself as your son. Your son. So you can chide me, beat me, anything you can do, kick me. So what problem for me? I should not have any false ego. Iti ekspadasyo tibro krodho prasamanayaha. Tasya putro Sidas Baba. Bharati Maharaj started laughing very loudly. Well, yes, I identify myself. So I asked to Bardha, why? Bardha speaking, the same thing are saying. If they can find your loophole, if they find was some, you know, some leakage, they can come and kill you. Be careful, Maharaj. Bardha speaking, if they find one leakage in your life, they can come and kill you. Okay, let them kill. If there is leakage, I have so many leakage. I'm not speaking, I have no leakage. I cannot speak. I have so many leakage. Maybe, but I am trying to make up. This much. So this way, if somebody asks me, acharan is important or preaching is important? Then I would say, acharan is very important. Because in front of acharanshil sadhu, they become very fear. They feel fear. They are afraid. They cannot write something. They cannot speak something in front of acharanshil sadhu. Acharanshil sadhu mean? Acharanshil sadhu mean? In his life, what do you mean by acharanshil sadhu? Who is established in acharan mean? You can go and discover in his life, everything is dedicated to Nityananda Prabhu. What do you mean by acharan? Acharan means seva. Acharan means seva. You are busy with seva all the time. All in his life, you can find something in his life. You can go and discover that each and everything, in toto, everything is dedicated for the seva of Guru. Nityananda, Balaram. That's why they are having so much power. In front of them, ordinary people, maybe they are, you know, sitting in a big chair, but still they cannot come and speak anything in front of you. If they speak two words, they feel afraid. What I can speak? Siddhanta Virod, maybe I can speak false Siddhanta. They cannot feel comfortable in front of pure Guru Vaishnava. So acharan is most important. Acharan is most important. You will have to see the whole world in relation to that Supreme Lord. You will have to discover, you have to see the whole world in relation to the Supreme Lord or in relation to Guru. Everywhere, every step, wherever you look, you can see my Guru is there in different form to protect me from danger. In my life also, my Guru Maharaj gone. My Guru Maharaj gone externally. But Guru Maharaj protecting me all the time. All the time protecting me, all the time. I feel Guru Maharaj giving me protection all the time. All the time Guru Maharaj protecting me. So you will have to look Guru, your Guru in different form everywhere. Everywhere you will have to look Guru. Maybe one beautiful lady coming in front of me. But I'll have to see my Guru Maharaj coming in this form to test me. Maybe some rich man coming to see I have any affinity for also Gurudev coming to test me. Everywhere you will have to find Guru. Then never you can feel problem. Never in your life you can feel, never in your life, no problem. Where is problem? No problem there. Only you will have to see your Gurudev everywhere. You can see your Guru Maharaj in me. I can also see my Gurudev in you. This is called Vaishnava Darshan. This is called actual Vaishnava Darshan, you will have to see. So Prabhupada was bound to re-establish this Vaishnava Rasava. At the Avirbhav Tithi of Vishnupriya Devi in the year of 1919, on 4th February, it was re-established, and then onward, Prabhupada started following the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur to implement all the desire of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, or Goswamis, all the way. So this way actually, Jiva Goswami Pad was bound to compile this Sarvasandarbha. It's one kind of big property for us. But under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, we will have to understand. Otherwise, bonded soul cannot understand the meaning. He can misunderstand. This way, you see, all those who are taking leading part, right from Rupa Goswami Pada, Sanatana Goswami, after that, in our after Sanatana Rupa, what to speak about Vishwanath Chakravarti, Baladev, then big darkness was about to come. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to fulfill this gapping. He is the seventh Goswami. He was the seventh Goswami. He was the seventh Goswami from whom we got our chance to get information about Vishva Vaishnava Rasa, everything, how to lead, what is Siddhanta. So, you see, this way, after Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, Saraswati Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Prabhupada wanted to implement this total desire of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I mean, and I am going to discuss about the agenda. There was different kind of, you know, segregation, group. There was different kind of segregation group. You can remember someday I was speaking that delegation of authority. Without any delegation of authority, if I am going to speak Harikatha and write something, it's not good. I know such acharya, those who used to throw the books of, you know, useless acharyas. They are writing all big, big philosophy without any direct feelings. I know. So without direct feeling, all useless. So delegation of authority is main thing. If I am not getting order to speak Harikatha, I have no right to speak Harikatha. Even if I speak forcefully, if I have no acharan, then all wrong philosophy I can speak. All rubbish I can speak. And public, when going to arrest me, then I can say, I heard it from Guru Maharaj. People, public thinking, he heard from Gurudev? How possible? But he is speaking, maybe it can be. This way, when public can understand he is speaking all false philosophy, then readily he changed. I heard it from Gurudev. At all, Gurudev not speaking that way. They like to save their own prestige. They like to insult Gurudev. Gurudev can never speak that way wrong. What is the main symptom? What is the main symptom of a pure Guru Vaishnava? What is the authenticity? How you can understand? You can go through their writings and speech. You can detect yourself that their writings are not in favor of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then you can arrest. They are not in line. They are out of Vishva Vaishnava Rasova. They are totally. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote in Kirtan that Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jani Jani Por in Bengali. Many times I told you, learn Bengali, learn Bengali, learn. Now you are requesting me to sing Kirtan. I have time. Eh? Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written his Kirtan, Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jani Jani Por. How you can arrest that he is totally out of order. Slightest deviation from the track of Guru Path, Padma Paramahansa Prabhupada can throw you away from bhajan. Maybe you can earn name and fame all over the world. What it concern to me? What it concern to me? So Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, if I find my father, mother or anything, my friend, my son, if they are against Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I like to throw them out. Gaura Bimukho, those who are averse, those who are averse to Gauranga Mahaprabhu, maybe they are near and dear one, I like to throw them. I also told many times, I also like to throw my father and mother. Who is my father and mother? I am not... You know, going to accept them in my life. Though they are not now, all gone, still I am speaking the truth. So, Gauro Bimukh Nijo Jani Jani Por, this explanation, Prabhupada speaking. Prabhupada, without Prabhupada, we are all blind. Without Prabhupada, we are all blind, blind, blind. If Prabhupada is not there, we are all blind. Be careful. So to get right information about Gauranga Mahaprabhu teachings, you will have to approach Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada speaking, Gaura Bihino Nijo Jani Jani Por, our Thakur Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote this way. So what is the meaning? Prabhupada is going to explain how we can understand they are against Gauranga Mahaprabhu. How we can understand? Because they are acharya. They are nice, you know, very nice preaching they are doing. How we can understand they are in the guise of big, big sadhu. How we can arrest them? The formula already spoken by Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking, how you can understand? They are actually demon. They are in the guise of, you know, sannyasis and this, that. They are sitting in the chair of big chairman, this, that. How? Prabhupada speaking, you can very easily understand. Very easily, you will have to wait and see. If you find they are against pure Guru Vaishnava, if you can find that against Siddhanta of Guru Vaishnava, this, that, they are doing all rubbish, then you can understand they are demon, they are not actually devotee. Prabhupada speaking this formula, how to arrest them. Prabhupada speaking, easily you can understand. You can find they are going to ignore pure Guru Vaishnava. Useless. They can invite some demon, like Kongso. Kongso going to invite in his Sabha, and big, Mustir, Chanuk, Chanur, Bhumasur, all, they are all demons, they are their friends. You know, follow, Jarasandha, they are making friendship with them. Because very good, they can enjoy their life. There is no service in the market, no amount of money is there so that we can start one business. It is a nice business. If you can take sannyas base and start earning, it's very good. People can pay respect and give money. Very good. We can lead our life very fancifully. Very good, na? Very good. We can enjoy our life. No service. I have not that much quality. So that I can get service in this competition market. So it's very good. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, if the number of sannyas and brahmachari red cloth increasing, you should understand this must be a plotting of Maya. Maya going to kick you. In different form, Maya going to cheat you. Maya going to kill you. Be careful. This is the arrangement of Maya. Maya always tried to put form so that... So, Prabhupada speaking, you wait and see, you can find. You can find easily that they are against pure Guru. Their activities, their acharan, their writing, everything can prove 100%. If you are blind, you cannot see. You are blind, number one, you cannot see. That's why. Otherwise, you can arrest. But you cannot see. You express doubt. How? And Maharaj speaking this way. How it is possible? Why not you go back to your country and lead your life very nicely? Why you take trouble come here? Foolish number one. So there is some groups. Prabhupada never wanted to give false honor to anybody. Sometime it was the technique of Prabhupada. If Prabhupada think, if I give some little honor to somebody and I can get big advantage in my Hari Bhajan, then it was the technique. I told you the key, very secret key of Hari Bhajan is that, someday I can explain, maybe next Hari Katha. Never you can understand the mood of Prabhupada. So, Prabhupada used to indicate this point. Pativrata ramani pati lagi koilo beshashyavan. Srila Bharti Maharaj also sometimes used to explain this point. this point. Pativrata ramani pati lagi koilo beshashyavan. Pativrata, the chaste lady, to satisfy husband, he was bound to serve some pros. We Gauriya devotee, we should be very clever. We should be very clever. You know, to understand this point. So, Prabhupada sometimes used to give some honor to some material personality. Like one chairman coming is a scientist maybe. Maybe some district magistrate, this, that. But it was not the desire of Prabhupada to collect some false pratishtha. Simply Prabhupada used to do because their important personality in this world, material world. If they come, then people can pay some extraordinary attention. Then automatically newspaper men, all media can come to catch their... It's a... Because media men always waiting. So automatically we can give the, you know, you can get the scope to speak something what on behalf of Gauriyama. So they used to invite them, not to honor them, to teach them. Suppose one sabhapati, chairman, he is from outside, he know nothing about Gauriya Bhajan. Know nothing. I was invited as a main speaker when our Prime Minister of India came, but I didn't think it necessary to go. Really so. Because there is no question of bhakti. Many times they invite me, personally they come, I was not ready to go. Because I know it is not bhakti. It is not bhakti. I don't need name. So, who can understand the mood of Prabhupada? Bonded soul, if you like to, and like to, you know, imitate Prabhupada, they can straightway go to hell. How they can understand the secrecy of the, you know, of Prabhupada? So it is a key. It is a successful key. It is the key through which we can get success. I can explain someday. Patibrata Ramani, Pati Lagi, Koyo Vesha Sevan. We are not, Prabhupada never wanted to give any false honor to anybody to get Pratishtha. Now, we are going to show honor to somebody so that he can also speak. I was deadly against. I am deadly against. In some sabha in Chandigarh, some Maharaj, foolish. I always allow him to sit in Sabhapati Asan chairman because I feel disturbance. I can concentrate in my Harikatha. I can speak Harikatha that much. I don't like to sit in the Asan. He is straightway, day by day, speaking all false. He is speaking to a bonded soul who is in the form of Maharaj. He is speaking Goswami. He is speaking Goswami. I say, why? He is a bonded soul. Bonded soul, stealing money, character loose, everything. He is speaking Goswami. Why? Because if he is going to speak Goswami, he can also speak. He is also Goswami. Openly in Sabha, you can go through that. That, you know, there was big camera, like, you know, film industry. I clearly declare in Sabha, mutual interest. I can speak him Goswami, so that he can speak me Goswami. Foolish number one. Goswami is not a cheap article that we can offer to. You can give me 50,000 rupees bribe, I can speak, well, you are Goswami. I can make urine on that money. Still, I cannot change my Siddhanta. Be careful. You know. So, there is some groups. First group, if you hear, you can go mad. Because nobody you can find in this world who is going to give honor to exact personality. Exact personality. At present, you can see all false honor. If there is thousands of devotees going to, oh, Maharaj is on, they don't understand the Gokisha Bhavanyas is, you know, honorable personality. He is staying like man. Oh, yes. So at present, such a, you know, personality we cannot find, who can exactly understand. If you can at all understand he is honorable, then you can pay honor to. Exact, you are going to pay honor, but your honor should go and touch the lotus feet of exact personality. You are busy with false person, false honor. So this is the system at present. But at the time of Prabhupada, that this was not the system. There was one group, first group, I can go on discussing this point. I can go on discussing about the, you know, agenda and all the actors and transcendental activities of Ishva Vaishnava Rasava, I can go under the guidance of Prabhupada. Manodo Mandali, you don't understand because you don't understand Bengali, you don't understand Sanskrit. Eh? Amani Manodo Habo? You don't know? Amani Manodo? Amani mean? I don't want any honor from you. I cannot expect. And I can give honor to you. Always I can give honor to you as mother, this, that. It's a different honor. I can father, I can give. But I don't like to get any honor from you. From heart. So it is called Manodo Mandali. There was some group and Prabhupada used to select them. So that in Vishva Vaishnava Rasava, right person can get right honor. But at present politics, right person you cannot detect, you don't like to detect. You cannot detect, it's not good. You don't like to detect a right personality. So you have not that kind of spirit that you can give honor to somebody. Only you are busy like monkey to give honor to each other. In fifth canto it is written, Sangsar Adhani, Sangsar, you know, Samudra, that description. If you understand at all, if you understand this Mool Sanskrit recitation, you can go. What is the painful position of those people, those who are, you know, in this, they have fallen into material world. So, those who are going to dedicate their life for the cause of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, they should be given honor. Maybe you have no spirit to give honor to him, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is ready to give honor to him. Who are you to give honor? You are bonded soul. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself ready to give honor to you. Not? Why not? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to give honor to Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was not selected as chairman in any big society. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dancing with the body, transcendental body of Haridas Thakur. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu busy to embrace Sanatan, who is already growing some skin disease. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ready to give honor to you. Don't try to expect any honor from France, Italy, Germany, nowhere. They are all bonded soul. If at all they are going to give honor, I am less interested to take it. At all, if I get some loveful honor by some pure Vaishnav, like Guru Maharaj, this, that, they can love me. This is not actually honor. They can love me, bless me. That I can accept. So this way actually, there is one group, those who are going to decide, very new, they are already on neutral platform, you should stand. Otherwise, contamination can come. So, they are waiting to offer right honor to right personality. Follow. Even after giving honor to them, still they go against Prabhupada, they fall down. Even after giving honor. But not all, some of them, started, they went on doing service. So this way actually, those who are going to do exact service, Bani Seva, Dham Seva, Nams, show exact service. Prabhupada is very careful. You cannot hide yourself. Prabhupada is very careful. Prabhupada is so careful, Prabhupada can understand, realize what is there inside my heart. Narahari Prabhu is the mother of Gauriya Math. Billions of mother I can put one place. I can get the gist of their feeling. But still I cannot make equal to the mood of Narahari Prabhu. So merciful, so merciful, so merciful. So merciful. He is waiting up to the last moment. If somebody coming without any prasadam, he used to give him prasadam. He is waiting up to the last moment. If nobody coming, then after that is like Draupadi, going to take prasadam. Night time, day time, so merciful. If some boy, some young devotee feeling weak, oh, going to serve him, Prabhu, you can take this one, you can, okay, this way. At present, you cannot expect. We are not going to run a boarding house. You always try to confuse. We are not going to run a boarding house so that all, you know, young batches can come and stay. One Uriya Thakur can cook nice, you know, chana rasa, this, that, fish and egg. We can take and go to our own service then. Gauriyamar does not like boarding house. Gauriyamar is a place where we should dedicate whole our life. If you can have the scope to stay in Gauriyamar one night, I can, with all Siddhanta Vichara, Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then be sure I am going to take dust particle from your lotus feet. Now you understand what I mean to say. To stay in Gauriyamar is to stay in Vrindavan. To stay in Gauriyamar is to stay with Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You have that kind of capacity. You are running one society, a very cheap mood. How much coming, how much spending? You need only your pratishtha. Let people die, let people go to hell. What it concerned to me? Maharaj, if you are going to open a spiritual organization, if by that organization whole world, whole society going to get corruption, going to get some negative things, then why not you close this society? Why not you close the society? Because you cannot render any exact service. Eh? You cannot do any perfect thing. Only you can make corruption total. All through our idealism, all through our speech and idealism, we should influence other. The other day I was speaking, successful acharya mean he is himself successful to engage himself in seva all the 24 hours. At the same time, he has the capacity to engage bonded soul in seva. I cannot give you any scope to take rest. I cannot give you. If you are going to take rest, within that gapping, Maya can enter and give you. You can take rest, but that you are taking rest should be one kind of seva. You are going to take rest, okay, it is my order. You can take rest. But that you are taking rest should be seva. You are sleeping, you are eating, you are looking, you are sitting, you are speaking, everything should be guided by your Gurudev, Guru Vaishnava. Even you cannot imagine, you are not habituated. Regarding Varnasam Dharma, I was discussing, many people went against me. They think Maharaj speaking, really so. You can become angry against me, but what I told, I cannot take back. Siddhanta means one gone. Even bow and arrow, if I you know, fix up on target, and if I allow this arrow to go, that arrow gone from my hand to touch the target, to hit that target, I cannot bring it back. Siddhanta coming is coming forever. Not, I cannot take it back. You can put pressure, I can take back my Siddhanta, not that. It is not Siddhanta then. Then it is not Siddhanta if I get back. I once spoken by me, it's all spoken. I can prove your marriage is one kind of joking. You marry, after one month, you throw. Are you don't understand the meaning of marriage. You don't understand the meaning of marriage. Foolish number one. You are fighting with me about Varnasam Dharma. You have your right. Foolish number one. Hearing Harikatha.
I cannot say that Ekalabha is a disciple of Dronacharya. You can shout as Dronacharya. Dronacharya not going to approve. I can discuss this point next day. Why I cannot approve? If you concentrate on some target, full concentration of mind can give you some power. That doesn't mean it is the power of Gurudev. That doesn't mean Ekalabha was successful when one target was fulfilled. That doesn't mean that was the mercy of Gurudev. I can discuss in details about this point so that you cannot fight with me. You can understand the genuine point. I can remember Patibrata Ramani, this point, and this point, Ekalabha. Surely I can discuss. Because otherwise, my discussion about Vishva Vaishnava Rasa is totally incomplete. I like to discuss about Kipaya Hari Kirtana Murti Dharam Dharani Varaharaka Gaura Janam Janakadika Vasa Lasingda Padam Panamami Sada Prabhupada Padam Panamami Sada Prabhupada Padam Panamami Sada Prabhupada Padam Vanchakalpatarusa Kipasindhi Bhavcha Potitanam Pavana Bhavishna Bhyo Namo.